Ding, ding.
Get closer.
Okay.
Closer.
Oh my God. Well, welcome back to the Jen and Jillian podcast. What the hell was that? What the actual hell was that? I just got booped by her glasses to my glasses. That was glass.
Ding, ding.
That was glasses on glasses.
It's contact. Aries season. I'm the Aries in this house, Navi.
Oh, yeah?
Ah.
Oh, we'll see about that. I got some coffee soap that we're going to use to wash our hands with.
Coffee soap?
Mm-hmm. What? Yeah, it's just coffee, but you rub it all around your hands like soap.
It doesn't clean your hands.
It does in a
That's
way.
That's coffee.
It's caffeinating. It breaks through the skin and enters your bloodstream, so it's caffeine.
Wait.
That's true. I'm a scientist.
I just like...
Don't fact check it, but it's true.
No, but like, you know how you can absorb stuff through your bloodstream really well through your skin?
Yeah.
Can you, is there like a caffeine that you can lotion?
Yeah, babe. Why do you think I squeeze coffee beans every night before I go to bed?
But so
I want
know
a little bit of boost of energy so I can stay up a little later.
There's lotion with caffeine in it, but it's meant to like firm your skin.
No.
Is
penetrate
there
the skin.
Like lotion that you can put on with caffeine in it, or is that dangerous?
Caffeine
then you
lotion.
Get caffeine poisoning.
Caffeine lotion. Caffeine.
Bath bomb.
Just caffeine bomb. Just get rid of the bath.
Okay. Sick.
What's that thing?
I don't know, but he's not sitting in his bed.
He has wood on his nose.
I know.
What is that?
It's stuck to his nose.
It is disgusting.
Can I hold him so that we don't do this?
I don't care what you do. I don't care what you and Sammy do on y'all's free time. Okay?
Like, Sammy. You know.
Anyway, this episode is brought to you by MeUndies. Oh my God, can't even talk. MeUndies, guys, if you don't want to do laundry, just get MeUndies. That's pretty much the simple solution here.
Okay, MeUndies, that doesn't make any sense. You still have to do laundry.
No, not if you keep buying MeUndies.
Julian, that's irresponsible.
MeUndies is 3 times softer than cotton and delivers right to your door. Okay, MeUndies equals less laundry. That is just science and facts. So go to MeUndies.com/JennaJulian. Get 15% off your first pair, free shipping, and 100% satisfaction guarantee. Or click the link down below. Also, guys, Postmates, from burritos to wine to corn, whatever you desire, Postmates is there for you to deliver 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Okay? So food, groceries, whatever you need, go to Postmates, download the Postmates app, and use code JennaJulian for $110 of free delivery credit for your first 7 days. Check it out. Get the food you love and get it fast with Postmates.
Thank you, sponsor.
So, what's new?
I just want to know if you can have a caffeine lotion that's not meant to like firm your skin that actually got you caffeinated. Will you Google it?
Does caffeine lotion exist?
Yeah, but like caffeinated lotion.
Well,
because I know there's all kinds of stuff like CBD and
there is caffeine lotion. There is caffeine lotion.
Can all be absorbed through
coffee,
the skin.
Body lotion for cellulite slimming.
That's what I'm
firming
saying.
Skin
it
tightening.
Firms your skin, okay. But is it meant to be caffeinating?
Okay, so apparently, yeah. Okay, caffeine doesn't really wake up your skin, but it might do something else. So I guess it's good at firming your skin. So you're wondering if it can actually. Can you stop looking at me? I'm at work, sir.
Sir, this is a workplace.
That seems like a little aggressive. I'm working, and I don't really know you too well, so. What did I just say? What did I just say? He just linked me again. Are you listening to this? Would you like some caffeine cream? Would you like some caffeine shampoo?
Will you just Google it and tell us the answer?
I'm Googling it right now.
Thank you.
I'm allowed to take my time.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Okay. I see energizing facial cream, facial... No, I think that's all just like bogus though.
No, it's not bogus.
Does caffeine cream... Okay, in short, skin creams containing caffeine can improve the appearance of your skin. And some studies suggest that caffeine cream may even work to destroy precancerous cells. Okay. However, you may need to apply these creams regularly. He's really going in here. Hey, guy. Sir.
So it doesn't get you caffeinated, though, is what I'm saying.
I don't think it does.
Right.
I don't think it has the effect that we're thinking of.
So you can't... What's the word? Subdermally... Dermally absorb.
I don't think dermally is a word.
Dermally absorb.
Babe, don't say dermally.
Dermally.
Okay. Well, here's the thing. If you take some coffee beans, concentrated with natural caffeine, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you rub them between your hands until there is no more caffeine or coffee bean. You just rub until there's nothing left.
Uh-huh.
Where does the caffeine go?
I guess not into your skin.
Oh, yeah, it does. Probably. We should do, honestly, here's how we should do an experiment. Okay? I should take a test, a physical test, to gauge of how caffeine I am, how caffeinated I am.
This podcast is already a mess.
Okay. And then I rub some coffee beans between my hands with friction until there's nothing left and they've fully absorbed into my palms.
Mm-hmm.
Then I do that same physical test and we compare the scores.
Clinical as fuck.
I don't see any variables. Do you?
No,
I feel like that's very controlled.
Extremely controlled.
And you have to judge my performance.
Okay.
In the physical test.
Okay.
So it'll be like a box jump and 3 mile run, headstand on the scale, handstand on the scale, backflip.
Why do they have to be on a scale?
So we can test my weight too, because I want to check my weight.
Okay.
Multitask.
The scale in the bathroom hasn't had batteries in it in like a year.
I put batteries in it recently.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Wow. So now you can finally do a handstand on that scale and see how much you weigh upside down.
Every single morning.
Any difference from when you're standing up?
No, I no longer weigh myself standing up, so I don't know. Only upside down.
Are you choosing to do a headstand or a handstand?
Handstand.
So your hands are on the scale, not outside of the scale, right? Because you'd weigh 0 pounds.
Yeah, if I wasn't on the scale, I'd weigh 0 pounds.
Okay. I mean, interesting choice, and I'm happy for you.
What? Okay. I feel like caffeine cream, I feel like if there's no product right now on the market that has caffeine in a topical lotion, what are you doing?
My pants hurt.
Your pants have feelings?
There's two dogs in my lap, and they just like put their legs wherever they want, so I have to adjust for a second.
Okay. I feel like if there isn't like an energizing caffeinated lotion, there's a big market.
Well, I feel like you can have caffeine gum, right? I've seen that and like mints.
Tablets.
And, yeah.
Like pills. Yeah.
Why not? Why doesn't it absorb through your bloodstream? Are the particles too large when you smart as hell?
Wasn't there like, I seem to remember someone.
When the particles hit.
I don't know where I saw it, but it was like caffeine vape. That seems like a really bad idea.
Yeah, that's like the alcohol that's vapor.
Yeah, what is that?
They can't like, I think, I don't know what the laws are in certain states, but like they were running into the issue that like it gets you so drunk that they can't like just sell that to people.
Because it would be way too easy to abuse.
Well, yeah, you're just going to poison yourself.
Yeah, that all seems like a horrible idea. I just feel like, how, like, my question all the time, every day almost, is like, why do I have to wake up and drink this coffee to feel normal? I mean, I'm fully aware I'm addicted to caffeine. I know that. I have a dependency. I have to drink multiple cups a day to feel normal. If I decide to not, I will get a headache. Like, I know how dependent I am on it. I'm fine with that. I'm cool with it. But my question is, how has it not, like, been invented to where like, I know there's espresso shots. I know there's, like, 5-hour energy. I know there's, like, energy drinks. But, like, shouldn't it be more efficient by now? Shouldn't
like
we?
What would you like
I don't
to
know,
do?
One tiny little fucking tablet. And it gives you 180 milligrams of caffeine. I mean, maybe that does exist. But I feel like I've taken caffeine tablets before, and they make me feel nuts.
Yeah.
They make you feel like when you take, like, a thermogenic pill.
Ooh.
If you guys have ever taken a thermogenic, they're, like, very wiry, like pre-workout, yeah. Fat burner. They're not good. Don't take them. They have a lot of shit in them that makes you jittery and can really cause anxiety and also a slew of physical problems if you're prone to them. But I remember taking a caffeine pill and thinking, oh, this might solve my issue here. And then I just felt crazy.
Mm.
And it gave me that thermogenic, like kind of frantic heart pacing feeling. And I don't want that.
I hate that.
Like, I think there's something wonderful about coffee in that it has natural caffeine. Same with green tea, right?
I don't really know enough about any of this.
But what I'm saying is with coffee, you get natural caffeine. It's not like, it's not altered. It's not put in a lab with like energy drinks are, you know, it's like you're drinking caffeine that naturally occurs in the coffee beans.
Yeah, I don't know where caffeine comes from. So I don't know.
And so it doesn't make, at least for me, it doesn't make me feel crazy. It makes me feel caffeinated. And I like that feeling. And I wish I could replicate that, but in a much smaller footprint in a What is he doing?
He wants to sit with you. Let him sit with you.
You're just flashing your square butt to the camera, dude.
Oh, Worm's having a daddy day.
He is having a daddy day. He won't leave me alone today.
I know he won't leave you alone.
What do you think of caffeine, bud? Remember when we made the TikTok whipped coffee last week, and we left it out on like a table for like 5 seconds, and Bunny walks over and just starts licking it.
Kermit put his whole head in my coffee the other day, like legit coffee, and tried to drink it.
Like a black coffee.
I don't know why. Maybe it's like chocolate to them. Like, I know obviously most people that own dogs know that chocolate is horrible for your dog and should never have chocolate.
Unless they like it.
No, but that once they taste it, they're like people. They sort of develop a taste for it. Like, they start to like it. So then if you eat chocolate in front of them, they're like, I've had that before.
Yeah. I even know though it's poisonous for them.
When I had Kermit, like, I got him in the summer and he was, I don't know, a baby. Mm. And then by that Valentine's Day, I had like a small little box of Valentine's Day Reese's peanut butter cups.
Yeah.
And he was still like less than a year. Mm-hmm. And it was like up on a counter, and he was, you know, doing the peach thing where he could hop up onto a bar stool, the chair that was there,
yeah,
and get up on the counter and mm-hmm. eat the food on the counter. And I caught him. He had eaten, you know, like 15 pieces of chocolate peanut butter cups as like a little baby dog.
Yeah.
And I'm like sobbing. I'm freaking out. Like, I'm thinking he's got chocolate poisoning or whatever.
Yeah.
So I called the vet, and she helped. This woman was brilliant. She's like helping me decide exactly how many pieces he ate, what his weight was, how much chocolate there is, because it's milk chocolate and a lot of it's peanut butter. Yeah. So like how much actual cocoa he ingested, you know what I mean? And if he was going to need to go to the hospital or not. And she was like, I did the math for you. Yeah. And it seems like he's probably going to, you know, maybe throw up, maybe get some diarrhea. He just had diarrhea, but that he was okay. And it was really amazing that someone way smarter than me was able to do that in that short amount of time and mm-hmm. help me. Because, you know, when you have an animal that's ingested essentially poison, the clock is ticking for sure. You to,
yeah. And it's very scary.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's but really awesome ever, that you got that person.
Ever on the phone. Since then, if I'm eating chocolate, he already decided as a very young little baby dog that sounds like something I'd like to eat. So it's like anything that has that like coffee sort of chocolatey rich scent and flavor, he's like trying to get from me.
I'll be like serving him dinner and he'll be like, actually, do you have chocolate? Is chocolate on the menu? I know you were going to feed me chicken, but do you have chocolate?
It's terrifying.
Yeah.
So I'm not really that surprised that like
they were both Kermit and Bunny drank out of your coffee.
They're trying really hard, especially since she's extra polite and doesn't like do Bunny, it on purpose.
I know.
But she's the size of a horse and can counter surf.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
They just put their head on the edge of the counter and can just counter surf and can eat anything up there
you're
that they
dangerous.
Want.
Yeah, you can get places. She's starting to get comfortable with it too. Like when we're eating dinner, she'll really get her nose up in there and like, what are you eating? And we're just like, hello, where did our shy girl go? And where did you come from?
It's a little bit like those videos of Arnold Schwarzenegger with his two, what they look like Shetland ponies or something sitting there eating food with him.
That's what it feels like having Bunny, having a full on pony.
Except he has two fucking horses in his house.
What is his life about?
I don't know.
What, like, does he live on a farm? I wonder.
I thought he lived in Southern California.
Yeah, on a farm or?
No, I thought he lives like in Bel Air, like one of those huge estates where they like casually have a small winery on a hill at the bottom.
Oh, well then, yeah, that's basically a farm because you can have animals there if it's an estate, right? Like it's.
I don't really know the laws in California about having livestock, but I did think that it was like. I mean, you guys will have to correct me again. I feel like this whole podcast, I'm just talking about things I have no idea about. But that it's not particularly like safe or sanitary to have livestock just like in your house all the time.
I would agree.
For whatever reason.
I would agree that's probably not safe or sanitary.
Arnold Schwarzenegger's just be eating fucking food with his horses in his house. Or are they donkeys? I don't know.
I don't know either. Who knows? I mean, They seem okay.
Well, if you really wanted to eat with your horses, couldn't you take your salad out to their little stable and go sit on a bench out there and eat with them? Like, why do they have to come into your house with their shit feet?
Shit feet.
That's what they do. They shit and they step in them. Why are they coming into your house with their shit feet?
I mean, if you want to have a household that allows your horses and ponies to walk in with their shit feet, then that's your decision to have their house. There's an episode of The Office where Dwight has some of his coworkers over to his farm because he lives on a farm. And Andy, like three times, steps in a giant pile of horse shit in the house.
That's funny.
That's like what it would be.
Well, I mean, to be fair, though, our dogs piss and shit and have piss and shit in the house. And also, Kermit pees on his own chest all the time.
Kermit pees on his own chest and arms.
So, like, I'm not really one to say, like, why would you let that horse in here with his shit feet when we have a dog that has shit and piss feet as it is?
He is shit chest. Piss chest. Piss chest. Sorry, not shit chest. No, he literally, he pees like a, kind of like a girl dog where they don't like lift up and pee out to the side. He just kind of pees up towards his face. But he like
but
looks
up. But
he
has that barrel chest.
And the barrel chest always gets in the way. And so it hits his chest. And then also he like sprinkles his whole hand and arm. So when we're on a walk, he usually pees the beginning of the walk. And I'm like, God damn, I'm glad you peed early because I'm not letting you pee all over your fucking hand and then jump into the Jeep and make my whole Jeep smell like pee.
Imagine how free he is, though. Like, the level of mental freedom, Julian, to just decide you
physical.
Have to... No, listen. To decide you have to pee, and so you just start peeing, and it touches any part of your body, and you're like... sick.
Just a disgusting
I want to see what's over there
fucking
now.
Guy.
No, he's free.
Okay.
And
that
disgusting.
Is no way to live because we are in a society, Kermit.
We live in a society,
we live in a
Kermit.
Society, Kermit, okay? You can't just pee whenever the urge strikes and just let it out. Hey. It's like when you're in the shower. Like, even when I'm in the shower and I'm peeing in the shower, it's like a conscious, like, okay, can I pee right now? Yeah, I'll pee. But even Kermit is more free than that in his everyday
He's
life.
So free. He's just peeing and wherever it goes, it goes.
God.
Hi.
What? What is it? Do you know we're talking about you? Is that why you're looking at us?
But like you, there aren't people that keep like chickens in their house, right? Don't they usually have like a chicken coop outside for the
well,
same type
babe,
of sanitary
there are people
reasons?
That do everything. I mean, people, yes, there are
well,
probably
you see them
people.
On YouTube, people with all kinds of stuff in their house, but get away from that, please. They must have some type of way of keeping things.
That was a real dick move.
Sanitary, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think
because can't you get all kinds of sicknesses from
probably.
Having livestock just be in your house?
Probably, yeah.
Am I dumb?
No, I don't think you're dumb. I think there's definitely rules for
no,
that.
Babe,
I just,
am
I think,
I dumb?
I think,
no, might, babe, am I dumb?
It's probably just hard to enforce those rules. What is happening right now? Does anyone want to let us work?
Hi.
Should we just have Bunny sitting here? Can I bring her up to my chair?
If Bunny, you want.
You want to sit in my chair? Come here.
She's all excited.
You want to sit in my chair? On a podcast? Come
here. Oh, God. Here we go. There's the horse. As we say, is it safe or sanitary to have a horse in your house and you just have a dog that's that size?
What do you have to say, Bunny?
Wow. Bunny, it's your first, like, actual podcast. Because you're always sitting in that corner.
You can lower
so
your
welcome
head.
To the
you can
podcast.
The mic's right here. There you go. Good girl. Bunny, you have sponsors? You want a segue? I'm staying like this.
She'll sit like that until you put her down.
Yeah. I'm just going to bring the mic over here. Is this cool, Bunny? All good?
Well, you might want to give her a break after a minute. I don't think that's like particularly comfortable
oh,
for her.
Oh, she loves it.
She does like being hugged and carried, but...
Yeah, she's a big baby. This has just turned into a dog cast. My whole life is a dog
cast. All
right,
now she wants to get down.
You want
to
get down? Okay. You know what also gets down? Is the micromodal fabric
Julian,
of MeUndies super soft underwear that you can get right now.
Wear them while you tend to your livestock in your house.
You can wear them while you have ponies inside your house. I'm not the cops, so you can do that.
I thought you were the cops.
No, I'm not
Plural.
Bella Candy. I am not the cops. MeUndies are so soft and they have onesies. And right now, while you're stuck at home, dude, rock some MeUndies onesies or MeUndies underwear or MeUndies socks or MeUndies bralettes, all of which Jenna wears pretty much on a daily basis. Right now, you can get a MeUndies membership. You don't have to, but you can. Babe, there is equipment up here. What are you doing? Babe. Oh my God, dude.
They're fighting over this one little pillow. If you sign up for a MeUndies membership, whole ass bed up here.
You can get site-wide savings, free shipping on your orders, and brand new prints that come out all the time with their MeUndies products. Please stop licking me.
They're finally happy. Look at them.
Guys, building your MeUndies collection not only gives you some soft underwear to wear and is delivered to your house and very easy, but it makes laundry day less and less frequent. Just saying. So, also, guys, they have buddy bands, which are the bandanas that are for your dogs. We put them on these guys all the time. They're really cute. Check it out by going to MeUndies.com/Edential and get 100% satisfaction guarantee, 15% off. 15% off. All right? And free shipping. Check it out. You won't be sorry. Also, Postmates, guys, whether you're hungry, thirsty, need a couple ingredients for something you're going to make for dinner, or you just have a craving for some chips or something, use Postmates. So download Postmates on iOS or Android. Find your favorites, restaurants, markets, whatever it is, and browse the menu. Choose what you want, and boom, Postmate will be on their way to your house or place of work, wherever you are currently right now, and they will deliver you at a very high level of convenience what you need 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Postmates is there for you, and you can track your driver in the app. It's very convenient. Right now, if you enter code Jenna Julian while in the app on iOS or Android, you will get $110 of free delivery credit for your first 7 days of using the app. So check it out. Postmates is wonderful, and they are there for you. I have completely lost control of this podcast.
No, babe, it's fine. No, babe, but it's fine. No, babe, it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
That's what they want. They always want to sit up here. We just have that one little pillow. But
where's my choice?
I'm saying it was a choice. It was a choice.
Where's my choice? Oh, God.
Speaking of TikToks.
Yeah.
What I wanted to do, because this probably doesn't make a very good podcast at all, but
what?
I don't really care.
What doesn't make a good podcast? Because
this morning, I'm getting there.
Oh, I thought you were like saying what we've done so far doesn't make a good podcast.
All facts. one of the TikToks that we watched on my video the other week, the doop 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 doop, and then shut the hell up, bitch.
Yeah, the Dr. Phil yeah.
soundbite. Julian on stream was like, he wanted to open the stream with that song. And he's like, what's that song? And I'm like, that's Annie Lennox. Have you never heard that song, like the whole song before? And he's like, no. And to be fair, Julian was born in 1992, and there's plenty of movies, music, a lot of things that you have not heard or seen, which is totally understandable, but sometimes I forget that we grew up.
Also, I kind of grew up without a TV for most of my childhood, so there's that too, but yeah.
Yeah, but like, just because I remember it doesn't necessarily mean that you remember it, and sometimes I forget.
Most of the time, I don't know.
We're 6 years apart.
Yeah.
But so I played him that song.
It's called No More I Love Yous, right?
Which I used to, that album, the Medusa album from Annie Lennox, I used to dance around to that whole fucking album so much. So this morning in bed, I was like, wait, so you don't know who that Annie Lennox is? Like, you've never heard this song by Annie Lennox or this song or like this song? What about this one? And I was just playing nostalgic music from the 90s. Late 80s sometimes for Julian, because I had to explain to Julian what the Lilith Fair was, because I loved the Indigo Girls. I loved Fiona Apple. There were so many like cool women in music that I really liked that weren't necessarily like mainstream pop artists, but were very successful. And it was just a cool time to be a little girl.
For sure.
You know, it was very empowering.
Yeah.
And the Lilith Fair was this giant festival full of just all women. And it was just such a good time.
Mm-hmm.
And you never heard any of that music.
No. And now it was all for a reason, because now we're here on this podcast where you can show it to me and we can get all of it copyright claimed right away. So let's get down to business. Let's play these songs and feel the music. This song actually makes me want to cry. It's a really good, like, amazing song.
Bitch, I've been crying to this song for fucking like 30 years. Okay, 20 years.
You don't have to yell.
Bitch, I've been crying.
Why are you looking at this?
Listen to these vocals, bitch. Listen to them. I hope she gets paid for this podcast. Copyright this. Set me up like an undercover cop. Like, I put this song on.
Yeah.
And what was your first reaction?
I want to cry.
Right?
I want to fucking cry, yeah.
But also, like, once it comes in, it also slaps.
Oh, yeah, it hits. Here it comes. Here it comes. Yeah, this makes me want to cry, fully. We may or may not have slow danced in the kitchen when you played
this.
We
did.
It's funny the way people who might not have grown up listening to this would discover that. Like, it was a stupid Dr. Phil TikTok, and now I know this song, you know? Oh, shit. Oh, shit.
But, like, I asked Julian, so obviously that song is in the TikTok,
mm-hmm, yeah.
Which, and what are you doing?
I'm mocking him because he's crying at me.
Whoever made that original sound, I have a lot of respect for. Because
for sampling 10, that.
10 into out the, of 10 yeah. song choice, love it, amazing. And then to put that is that just dark, I don't need to explain why it's funny, okay?
No, it's brilliant.
Fucking hysterical, no. And I love it. But
you
also,
could argue, hold on, what you're saying is you could argue the person who made that TikTok and decided the analytics goes underneath the Dr. Phil saying, shut the fuck up, bitch, or shut the hell up, bitch. They are an artist in and of themselves.
Bitch, you really did something. Artist. The artistry. The curation of noises here really just, it's like how I laughed so hard at Act Up in the Wind.
Yes.
This is just a curation of amazing, beautiful, wonderful thoughts.
Yep. I love it.
But this song, really, it just hits different.
Yeah, that song does hit different.
But that's why I was like, you've never heard any like, except Blows My Mind. You have so many good songs to listen to mm-hmm. and to hear and that mm-hmm. you didn't know that she was part of the Eurythmics and all that Sweet Dreams and all the songs you've definitely heard before. That's Annie Lennox.
Mm-hmm.
But then I played this one for you and I was like, how have you not heard this? You've never heard this song before this morning?
I've definitely heard this song.
Like okay,
every
good.
Other human on earth, I've heard this song.
Slaps! Slap me!
Put it up to the mic.
I don't want it to be too loud because then you yell at me. I don't know the threshold. No,
you're being far louder than this
song. No, you're
being
far louder than this song.
I'm not being loud. you're being far louder.
You
want
to fucking listen to some Annie Lennox and argue over it? Fight me, dog. 1v1 me in the gulag.
What the hell, Jeff? 1v1 me in the gulag? Who are you?
What do you want me in the gulag?
Oh my god.
Why are you laughing?
I'm not laughing. I'm smiling. I'm having a good time.
You're having a good time listening to Annie Lennox?
Yeah.
Well, good. Because after that, we're going straight to the Indigo Girls.
Oh my god. Peach, I'm podcasting. Why are you reaching for me? What do you need? What do you need from me?
Listen to this fucking shit right here. Tell me this shit doesn't hit.
Oh, God. Help me.
It doesn't hit you right in the 90s when you was born. Listen to that fucking guitar.
I'm listening. Stop interrupting. You're interrupting it by screaming.
Vocals. And then you had to bring up reincarnation over a couple of beers. Why are you laughing?
I'm waiting for you to yell.
Oh, hell yeah. Fuck it up. Oh, oh, fuck it up. Oh, oh, hell yeah. Listen to that. Oh, it's so beautiful.
It is beautiful.
Listen to their harmonies. She's such... It's lovely. Lovely.
It is beautiful. Really, really beautiful. Most YouTubers are fucking digging through the trenches on the audio library to find something so they won't get copywritten, and we're just out
here fucking... I'm ready to watch a full movie.
Jenna thought we should watch a whole movie for the podcast.
No, I wanted to watch a full movie for my video.
Oh, that's what you were saying. Yeah. So like... You can.
Well, so I think that I can.
Can you? Okay, interesting point you got there. Go on.
No, so I have to find a movie that's like, you know, maybe not with a big production, but like someone's actual film.
Okay.
And maybe I'm not asking to monetize it. I'm just asking them not to imprison me and throw me in jail. For distributing their work. Like I would have the right to watch your video on my platform.
Yeah.
But I'm not trying to make any money of it. And you're also not going to sue me for the people that are watching it. You know,
well, like, I mean, depending,
think of all the people that were in college and made a short film.
Okay. Like, okay.
That, well, kind of,
if
thing,
you're talking about that small of an independent production,
you, it's can, still a fucking movie.
Hold on. I went to film school. It's my turn to talk.
Oh, he fucking went to film?
Yeah. School. So let me speak now.
Well, he won me in the gulag.
Okay. If you're talking about a tiny independent college film, you're absolutely entitled, I mean, with permission to monetize fair use of that film, I'm pretty sure. Like, you don't have to forego making money off of a video just because it's someone. I mean, like, you can do fair use and talk about it and comment on it.
Will you let him sit with you? He really wants.
He was, and then he had to get up. But I think that'd be funny. I think that would be an interesting video for you to sit there and review someone's film. Like, whether or not it be like a college or, you know, semi-professional. I don't even know how you classify it, but like a film, a small independent production. But they did just add on Twitch. Did you hear about, like, they added like all of the Amazon, not all of them, but there's like a selection of the Amazon Prime movies and TV that you can now watch on stream.
Yeah, I think
because of Amazon and Twitch Prime.
See, that's really cool.
That is cool, but it's like more.
But I want to do it on YouTube.
So do it. I'm sure you could. I'm sure there's so many people who have made films, short films, whatever, that you could react to. This is not our podcast. We have been taken over by the animals. They are licking on the table in front of us. Kermit won't stop grumbling and crying.
Anyways, this is my favorite, one of my favorite probably artists of all time. Her name is Björk. Even though it's spelled like Bjork, and sometimes I say Björk. It's Björk.
It's pronounced Björk.
One of the most underrated artists, in my opinion, of all time. Visually, aesthetically, sonically, way before her time, did whatever she wanted, said whatever she wanted. A brilliant artist, person, human being. Vocals, unmatched. Her movie that she did, Dancer in the Dark, we'll never be able to forget it, ever. Hauntingly beautiful, sad, tragic, amazing. 10 out of 10. Watch YouTube videos of her. Like, this song brings me so much nostalgia. And it brings you none.
Sorry?
Hold my hand about it.
This is fun.
When your boyfriend doesn't want to listen to Björk with you.
I'm good. I'm just a bit distracted.
What are you distracted by?
I'm trying to listen. Are we going to get a strike on our channel?
Yeah, absolutely. Strike me. Is this beautiful?
It is beautiful.
All right, why don't you play me a song that brings you a great level of nostalgia?
Okay. What? 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 This brings you nostalgia.
What does this make you nostalgic for? I just wasn't ready for all of the Chumbawamba.
Okay, so here's why that brings me nostalgia.
Okay.
When I was three years old in my life, I was taught how to ski. because my mom is psycho and thought it was a good idea to teach a 3-year-old how to ski.
Yeah, but a lot of people do that. Like yeah. swimming, skiing, all kinds of stuff. No,
she's psycho in the best way. I love her. Yeah. I'm psycho like her. But yeah, I was like 3. She was like, yeah, you're going to ski. And as a 3-year-old, I fell quite a bit because most 3-year-olds who ski tend to fall or do anything. They tend to fall while they're doing it because they're 3 yeah. years old.
Yeah.
And so I forget. It was like my mom and me and my sister and when we got older and we skied a lot growing up, we would all sing this song because my mom like kind of felt like it was the anthem of us on the slopes. I get knocked down, but I get up again. You're never going to keep me down.
Wow.
Because when I get knocked down, I get up again.
Wow.
And so we would just sing this on the slopes. We would sing it on the chairlift. And so now every time I hear it, I just think of being miserable and cold, falling in the snow.
That's cute, though.
But actually having a good time.
Aww.
Yeah. And actually, I did this thing. My mom can attest to this. I forget if we've ever told the story, but I did this thing as a very small child learning how to ski from my mom, who was and is an incredible skier. I decided I wanted to go really fast all the time. And that was before I knew how to stop. I didn't know how to stop. I just knew how to like ski. And I sort of knew French fries and pizza, but you know, when you're going fast, pizza's only going to do so much. You know what that is?
Yeah.
Okay. With your skis.
Yeah.
So I would like a little tiny 3 or 4-year-old rocket ship, just start flying down the mountain and use people as my brakes. So Julian. I would just launch myself into people, into strangers. I was so small though that it like really, you know, I wasn't hurting anyone.
But it's still pretty dangerous.
But it was still pretty dangerous. It
could be really dangerous.
And so that's how I learned to ski. I would just ski into people.
That's terrible.
You hear this noise he's making? He is the most moody fucking dog of all time.
Grumble, grumble. Grumble, grumble. Because he's screaming at you because he wants you to pay attention to him.
Let's grumble ASMR real quick.
Meanwhile, Peaches is clawing the mic. Okay, it's the Peach and Kermit show.
Yeah, it's the Peach and Kermit podcast. All right, here.
Peach, there you go.
Here. I'm trying to get you to grumble, my guy.
No, he doesn't want to grumble. Here. No, just let it sit there and ignore him, and then he'll scream.
Okay.
Oh, he just... he knows you're messing with him.
I'm dude. Not messing with you. Right, I love
alone.
You.
Just leave him alone.
Okay.
Stop. You're so happy.
What the hell? Hi. I love you. You're sitting in front of me.
Julian, stop. Leave him alone.
I'm not doing anything.
It's the Peach and Kermit show.
Okay. Just let him talk.
She's just yawning and he's just crying. I gave them a bed on top of the podcast table.
This is like every morning when I feed them breakfast and then they go outside, do their business and come back and cry at me.
Yeah, like what else do you want?
I don't know what else. I don't know what else.
Anyways, that's a really cute story about skiing into people and listening to Chumbawamba.
Yeah, we probably had, we listened to a lot of Alanis Morissette.
Didn't we all?
Yeah, we took road trips and my mom would play us Alanis Morissette, so I learned some of her music.
She was one of the artists that performed at the Lilith Fair.
Was she?
Yeah.
So I did know of the Lilith Fair, in a sense, right? So when you were there... Watching, were you there physically?
No, I wasn't there.
Were you there physically?
Mentally,
emotionally. You were, I was also there. So we were there at the same time.
Wow.
What time did you get there?
Amazing. 4:45.
I was there at 7. I was a little later.
Oh, we missed each other.
Yeah, you showed up way early to the party. I was way cooler, I think.
Yeah, I was the early one to the party.
Yeah, you were 7. I was 1.
Anyways.
Yeah, what?
Any other songs that you really liked growing up?
I don't know. A little bit of Smash Mouth. Oh, my God. Wait. Oh my God. I think I've told you this. I made a music video with my brother and dad when I was. What is that?
Is it on YouTube? Can we watch said music video?
What is this song? Oh my God. It's a U2 song. Elevation by U2. We shot a music video to this song, a full on music video.
Uh huh. Is it on YouTube?
I don't think it is, but I could probably find it. Bad. I think my dad would definitely have a copy. Hold on,
play us Elevation.
Do you want to hear Elevation?
Yeah, it's probably all installed on all of our phones already permanently. Oh,
good joke. Never heard that one before. It starts with a plane sound because Elevation.
You want to 1v1 me in the gulag?
What the hell? Everybody gets a piece of this podcast.
Oh, now we're really fucked. You don't fuck with U2. You don't just listen to U2.
Also, yes, we had almost 300 episodes of our podcast. Yes, we have a really nice preamp and decent microphones. No, we still haven't figured out how to play music through our headphones and make it not from our phones. So we're don't have an audio engineer. We're just going to do it this way. So
if you have a problem engineer.
With it, just make sure you take it up with our complaint department. It's called the comment section. No, I could really ask my dad. I'm sure he has a copy of it, and I'll have to review it.
You'd also have to get Marlon's consent.
No, fuck his consent. Oh, I'm putting damn. That on the internet. No, my dad's the director. He owns the rights to the music video. You two owns nothing.
Damn.
It's only their song. If I find it, I will put it out there for you guys to watch. But we shot it. Like my dad, he's a filmmaker, and he had a lot of cameras when we were growing up. So we would be his guinea pigs from time to time to film things. And then I, you know, sort of just fell into like liking it myself. But we went down to the beach. Yeah, but he was, you know, he's also a filmmaker. Yep. But we went down to the beach, the Santa Monica Beach, and there was this like, what do you call it? It's like this like walkway with this overhang of it's like really pretty, right? And we would run in and out of the posts, and we filmed this whole thing. We were there for like a whole day. It was so. I would say U2 and.
I would like to see it.
Yeah. Well, maybe we'll all get to see it someday. And I actually did some more stuff. You know what? I should really just like raid my dad's drives and see what he has. Yeah. Because I'm sure there's some good stuff.
Well, my mom recently brought that DVD with her that we watched, remember? Of me and my brother.
Yeah, that was so, oh my God, that was so cute to watch.
Yeah, and I was a little girl.
We
went to the Brooklyn Zoo with my aunt who's lived in New York.
Oh my God. Years. And she's just asking you questions and you're just talking on camera and you're like the cutest little girl. Oh my God. The way you like answered the questions, just kept wanting to talk about it and you were so excited and it was your aunt who was filming, right?
Yeah.
She just kept asking you questions and you were just like, yeah. And then
we went to the Brooklyn Zoo and I was hanging out with a little girl there and I hope that girl grew up and is really cool and fun.
What was her name?
Doxer. We were just there looking at like whatever that exhibit was together and having fun.
Yeah.
And did you see how annoying my brother was?
Your brother was on some shit. Isn't he annoying? I did to my sister.
He's so annoying.
It's your job as a brother. You have to annoy your sister.
He's so annoying.
I would literally try to, like, because you would clearly get so riled up. And that's what he looked for. And that's what I looked for when I was pissing my sister off, too. What animal is he? All right,
Carm, are you really having that hard of a time today?
My guy. He just went into the bed with no cushion. This is the cushion. It's just the floor.
Oh, now he's all upset that it's up here and he just figured that out.
Oh, my God. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this. We got to stop now.
He just screams from the ground. You pranked me. There's nowhere to sit fun down here.
If you guys have any other ideas for what we can do on the podcast that may not, result in us giving all of the revenue to you two.
It's definitely you two that's going to get that.
Let us know in the comments. And also, if you have any ideas of what we could be doing for Aries season to celebrate a certain Aries day of celebration coming up, I'm open to suggestions. It's your birthday. So let me know. And
I'm going to bake you a cake.
Okay. I'm going to eat the whole fucking thing.
You want chocolate or vanilla or funfetti?
Mm-hmm. Not Funfetti. You did that for me already.
Chocolate?
Vanilla.
Vanilla?
Chocolate.
I don't, that's not a clear answer.
I'm really looking forward to this kick. I'm expecting it to be good. Oh my God. Okay, he's getting violent. All right, we'll see you guys next week. Thanks for hanging. Love you.
Okay, we're going to come hang out with you now, Kerm. Are you happy? Yes, we're all done. Yeah. See you guys next
week. See you guys.